your lesson 3, basic part modeling. How do you choose the best profile and plane for sketching? We'll also try to learn extrude a sketch as a cut. We'll try to add few hole wizards, then also we'll do some fillets. Then we can again go back to sketch, do some editing. Later, as time permits, we'll do some basic drawings of the part you have created, and we'll try to make changes to dimensions. So what we got is, when you start your part modeling, we have to choose again the profile. Always take a bit of time to draw what type of profile, and also the plane selection. Okay, so in this case it's a circular disc, so we'll start with the base as a circular sketch. Then we can extrude it later. We keep on adding material or deleting material. So in this case, the profile looks like a L shape, but it is drawn on a right plane. Here you could see it could be drawn on a top plane or a front plane, or it could be also drawn in right plane. Not a big difference. Yeah, you can rotate it. Yeah, you can rotate it. Whereas this looks like a mechanical element, a wishbone. Silence, please. I'm recording the lectures. So here, this is a dome type of a shape. We started with a simple semicircle. Then you can combine it with an open rectangle here. Then you got your dome, extrude it, then you can cut and add holes. So deciding on the profile to start with, once it is decided, then the choosing of the plane and the placement of the model, because this actually affects your assembly as well. Okay, so say for example, if so this is one of the versions of the electric vehicle. You know, when you are trying to load these files, it takes a lot of system memory. But to start with, when you look at the body placement or a chassis, if I open up my planes, I have inserted in this case my chassis first. Okay, and the chassis, when you look at this particular chassis here, it's been placed on the front plane. Okay, then depending on that, because your first insertion of the part in the assembly is where you're drawn it as a front plane, you're adding your rest of the stuff, body, and in this case wheels or discs. It's very clear with the addition of which plane they are going to be drawn and how you're going to assemble them. Basically your mates. Sometimes these mates could be used on the plane. Planes will always help you. So selection of the profile, selection of the plane is quite critical to start your part modeling. So he has shown here as an example the same part being placed in different planes. Okay. So you can see this is placed on the top plane, here it is placed on the front plane, here it is placed on the right plane. But different orientations, because you have to be careful in terms of the placement, this is going to affect the assembly. Even in the drawing also it might affect. Okay. Because in the drawing sheet sometimes you are limited by only three views. Okay. And you have inserted in a wrong plane, it may not be visible in these three views, then you have to insert one more view. So you are actually taking that future considerations of your making part as well as making your drawings, fabrication and your drawings. Okay. So in this case study, he is asking you to create this simple bracket. You can see it has got some holes, few holes and few cuts and some fillets here. Okay. But you can interpret from this basic part, there are two solids. Okay. You see one rectangular block here and the other one with a dome shape here on the top. Okay. When you combine these and you have a solid, then you can add your fillets and holes. You are actually now trying to remove the material. Okay. So your base object solid is critical. Then deciding on the plane, the sketch plane in this case is placing in the top plane. So we are actually starting with the rectangular on the top plane. Okay. Because addition of the base solid, you can use those faces as well rather than using your basic sketch planes. That I'll tell you later how you are doing it. But in this way, in this example anyway, we'll be using one of the face to draw this the other solid. Okay, so there are two solids. Deciding on the plane, you can start with the rectangle. Okay, so it is basically 40 by 100, and you are snapping your origin in this corner point here. Okay, so I'll open up my close my EV challenge file. Now he's asking you to select the plane and sketch and select a corner origin, expand it, and it press escape dimensions. Mention this and this one. Once drawn, it will ask you to extrude it by 10 mil. Thing with the extrusion, you need to observe from now on your directions either way from that particular plane, extrude it completely opposite, but I can also plane, I can extrude it my mid plane. In this case I can hit my plane, this my feature this time. Clearly see my plane, where my plane is, where my sketch is, and how the extrusion is done. I'm adding 5 mil direction. If I want one direction, I'm increasing 10 mil. I'm increasing the other direction, I'm increasing. Default referencing and my extrusions. The same sketch, rectangular sketch 140, I have extruded it 10 mil above and 40 mil below. Okay. But in this case, he is asking you to blind, that should be fine. Material now, I'll just play. This is again, look for the orientation on your this particular. So selected this. So I will make this one normal first. Once it is normal, I will select a line. The best thing is always to find a midpoint. After finding a midpoint, I will coincide, I'll snap the edge, then I will hover the across the midpoint. I will finish my line 1 and I will draw a vertical line. If you want to draw a tangent arc, all you need is come back to the point. It will start changing that particular plotter to an arc. So in this case, I am drawing a semicircle. Before snapping that, make sure that it is coinciding with the start vertex point. I'll snap that one. I'll snap the initial vertex point again by drawing one more vertical line. Okay. So this finishes my semicircle, and that will allow me to put a dome. Okay, but still my sketch is not fully defined. Only you can see this line is fully defined. Okay, so what I need is basically this origin point. So this semicircle center has to be defined. Okay, so I'll go into my smart dimensions. I'll try to define this point from this the fully defined line. So this length is given to you as 35. Okay, then also dimension, this particular center with the edge here, because I know it is also coinciding with the origin, so I can snap this one and make this one to 50. Okay. Later I also want to define, see already there is, see you are sometimes when you are drawing the semicircle tangent arc, there might not be a tangency. You need to externally add this relationship. So in this case, if I delete this tangency, how do I add it to make sure that this particular arc is tangent to this line? Is go into relationships, add a relationship, select your arc and select your line and make this tangent. Okay, so this is how you add tangencies. We commonly come across these tangencies quite often because we randomly draw some arcs and you want it to be a tangent arc. Okay, so you've got your center, we know the center position, and also we need to define this radius. So again, go into smart dimension, I'll just snap this radius, and the radius here. As soon as I insert my radius, the sketch becomes fully defined. Because these lines are vertical, they are in relationships, and they are actually using that midpoint also into the relationships, because I snap across that midpoint as well. Okay. So if this is how you define the sketch, once the sketch is fully defined, you can go into your features, extrude. In this case, by default, it will come because this is it doesn't matter, it can overlap this particular length, it doesn't matter. So, once extruding, you can solids are done now. Okay, now we'll try to add some cuts. In the bracket bottom here, so you wanted to make a groove here in the bottom. So I add it is again select the this, go into your sketch mode, a corner rectangle. You can snap on this edge, and I want you to one to the other side of the new solid you have added, snapping the same edge, but just insert a very small rectangle, because this cut has to go very narrow. Okay, so again make this one normal. Normal, you'll make the rectangle, existing rectangle. All you wanted to try is that add based on the relationships, try to define this sketch fully defined. So in this case, I'll go into add relationships, add a this particular edge on the solid, and I'll solid and the line on the sketch. I'll select the edge. This is how you clear your selections. If you have wrongly selected any edges, you can clear the and go back and redo the selection again. And you want them to be collinear. That of this rectangle are become now fully defined. Okay. All I need is the thickness of this rectangle. I can go into smart dimensions, two edges, and make be the that's what you view in the text. So once I this to go into my features, and now I want another feature called extrude cut. Okay, I'll select the extrude cut, the direction through all you want it to be through all. I can all I see is just say okay. So here in two here. Once you are done with this, with the model view orientations, you can orientation to a by default it is.
So are these two features, are they merged now?
Are these two features means you are on adding the features, you are changing.
Can you take them apart? The vertical and the horizontal.
No, you can't, because this is a single part, you can't. But if you want to have that flexibility, you have to draw them as a separate parts and assemble them in the assembly. Okay, you can draw this block as a separate part and this one as a separate. Until you draw them separately and make them assembly, you'll have that flexibility. If not, you can't. Okay, they will be adding on one top on the other. Okay. All I can do is I can feature suppress this one. If you want some different shape to be added here, now you can do that, because I have suppressed that particular feature. You can start adding the fillets. This is the fillets are features options, so you can select a fillet as soon as. We'll talk about these various type of fillets later, but we can use this constant radius fillet. The fillet is of 3 mil. Okay. No, the first one is of the 8 mil. 8 mil to your edges. So once you start selecting, but when you clear this selection, it will come up. So the computer is the program is actually quite smart in terms of giving you the selection as well. You don't have to worry and select all the edges by default. Depending on the shape, sometimes it's very clear for us, this is what the edges will be filleted. So in this case, we'll select the four edges. it is coming up. So select the the radius of the fillets by variable radius, but for the moment just do as a constant radius fillet. So this is 8 mil. Also due to select the one edge inside, so you can add to that selection. That's all. I think there are 6 edges that need to be added. 1 8 mil. Yes, added inside the cut, then on the sides. Then he is asking you to fillet, which is a round fillet, but it is of 3 mil chain. So you select the giving you by default what you can add. Okay. So in this case, we'll use the edge. As soon as the edge, it is giving me the. Okay. I think this will do connect. So in this case, now 17 edges. I don't have to add individual edges. Whatever the computer is inferring, if that is what you feel good, right, then you can select that option. So I selected these options. As soon as I select all the 17 edges, okay, all I need is say yes. So it has, okay. So what we are going to do with this particular part is the holes, but we'll just roll back one fillet up, because so go to your hole wizard selection. This is again it as a feature. Once you have selected the hole wizard, he's asking you to select the hole type. In this case it is ANSYS metric drill sizes. So these are pretty standard holes that you can insert in the solid. Okay, so you can see counter bore, very simple hole that you need. Depending on the diameter, you can change the diameter depending on the design intent given to you. So now with the placement of the part, once you have selected the type of the hole, position of the hole, general 3D sketch, all you select the plane, see how are it the scale plotter actually changes with the sketch. But for this I need an edge reference. So in this case I want to know which side of the edge is he trying to use. So I select this particular diameter edge. And all what I am doing is, once I selected it, it is giving that particular edge. Okay, so snap that one again. One more hole here, snapping the curve. Once I find the center, I'll release that particular hole. Okay, we'll talk about different type of holes later, but in this case we'll try to snap as a very simple hole of a diameter 7. So once it is selected, your hole is automatically added now. Your fillets, what will happen is that you want that lost for me. I can find it from the other side. Once you have on the second extrusion, boss extrusion, again you can do the same thing. You can roll back to your fillets. rod is selected. I want to know the type of hole here, but it is actually the counter bore one. Type of hole size is I think it's lift as a standard, but position again I'll use a 3D sketch, snapping that corner point and the center of that semicircle. I'll press escape. So your contour board is done. I'll roll back my fillets. So this is the part which is actually being created for you in that case study. Okay. So what you had learned from this lesson today is basically adding more features, especially the features like extrude cut, and about your fillets, adding your fillets, and also a few holes, standard holes, how we can insert and position the holes. Later I'll tell you how you can move this particular hole positions. We can edit these hole positions. You can fix the hole positions as soon as you, sometimes if there is a design change, you want these holes rather than on this side, we want it to be on this edge, then we can always move them. Okay, how I do that is, if I go into my hole feature and find that 3D sketch, your normal sketch is telling you the hole dimensions. So if I expand the other holes as well, your sketch is telling you the type of roll revolve feature is being used to do this hole. Okay, but you and edit this particular sketch. When you go into that edit mode, by default it comes with these coincidence relationships. All you need is, you got to, on the plane is fine, but you want to remove this coincide relationship, delete this coincide relationship. Then you have to do the same thing for this one. You got to delete this coincide relationships. Once it is deleted, this point is actually free now. Now I'll go into my smart dimensions, dimension one to this edge. It is 8, yeah, and dimension from this edge as well. So this is 8. So if I want to change this one, if I want to say for example, if I want to change it to this one to 20, I can move my hole now. I already moved my hole. I say yes and exit my sketch. Now I'll use my rebuild options. It is already rebuilt. The hole of this edge on this side is actually moved. Okay. Later we can use this part to make a drawing. All you need is file, make a drawing from this part. First it is asking you to save this part. You can save the part